Welcome to Grab and Go Info. Natural language processing terminologies are frequently asked during data science and machine learning interviews. In this tutorial, we will talk about the top 10 natural language processing concepts interview questions and how to answer them. Let's get started. Question 1. What are vocabularies, documents, and corpus in NLP? Document is the unit for natural language processing. If an NLP project has 1,000 reviews, each review is a document, so we can say that the project includes 1,000 documents. Corpus is a collection of documents. In an NLP project with 1,000 reviews, the corpus consists of all 1,000 reviews. Vocabulary is a collection of unique words or tokens in a corpus. If we remove the duplicates from the 1,000 reviews and there are 2,000 unique words left, the 2,000 unique words are the vocabulary for the NLP project. Question 2. What is tokenization? Tokenization is the process of breaking down the raw text into small chunks called tokens. The tokens can be characters, part of words, words, or sentences. Word tokenize from NLTK breaks sentences into words. We can see that the sentence text string becomes a list of words and punctuations after tokenization. The link for the code is in the video description. We can also tokenize at the sentence level using sent tokenize from the NLTK library. The string with two sentences is broken into two individual sentences and a list after sentence tokenization. Question 3. What are stop words? Stop words are a collection of words that are commonly used in a language but do not provide much meaning for the text. Some examples of stop words are the, in, and at. The popular Python NLP packages such as NLTK and SPSI have a list of default stop words, but the list can be customized by adding or removing words based on project needs. The code for listing, adding, and removing stop words from NLTK is provided. After importing the NLTK library and downloading the stop words for English are saved in a variable called stop words. After printing out the list of the stop words, we can see that the default English stop words list has 179 words. New stop words can be added to the list using the extend method. We can see that the number of stop words increased from 179 to 181 after adding two new stop words. The stop words can be removed from the list using list comprehension. The number of stop words decreased from 181 to 177 after removing four stop words, I, me, my, and myself. After the stop words list is finalized, we can remove the stop words from the tokenized sentence using list comprehension. Question 4. What is n-gram? N-gram is n continuous sequence of tokens in a document. The most commonly used n-grams are unigram, bigram, and trigram. Unigram has one token, bigram has two consecutive tokens, and trigram has three consecutive tokens. When there are more than three consecutive tokens, the name represents the number of tokens. For example, when there are five consecutive tokens, it is called 5-gram. To implement ngram in Python, we imported ngrams from the NLTK library. String is imported to get the list of punctuation. This is because punctuation will be removed before implementing ngrams. After the punctuations are removed, the tokens only include word tokens. We set the n equals 5 for the 5 grams. The output shows that 5 consecutive tokens starting from each token are created. Question 5. What are stemming and lemmatization? The goal of both stemming and lemmatization is to reduce the words to their common base form. Stemming chops the end of the word to get the base form. Lemmatization removes the inflectional ending of a word only and returns the dictionary form of the word. Stemming is usually faster than lemmatization but not as accurate. In the example below, we can see that the word university was chopped to universe by stemming and kept as university after lemmatization. Question 6. What is count vectorization? Count vectorization converts a corpus to a matrix of token counts. It produces a sparse representation of the token counts where each token is a column and each document is a row. The value represents the frequency of the token for the row. Fitting the input text using count vectorizer from Sclearn automatically creates IDs for each vocabulary in the corpus. We can see that in the example corpus with two sentences. Data science is fun, and data science helps us to make data-driven decisions. There are 10 unique vocabularies, and they are assigned to IDs from 0 to 9 in alphabetical order. Transform method produces the count vector values. For example, the first column is at index 0, which represents the token data. Because the word data appeared once in the first sentence and twice in the second sentence, we have the value of 1 for the first sentence, and the value of 2 for the second sentence. Question 7. What is TF-IDF? TF-IDF stands for term frequency inverse document frequency. It measures the importance of a term in a document against all the documents in a corpus. It increases proportionally to the number of times a word appears in the document and decreases by the frequency of the word in the whole corpus. The formula is TF-IDF equals TF times IDF. TF stands for term frequency, which measures how many times a term occurs in a document. We expect a term to appear more times in longer documents than in shorter ones, so the term frequency is often normalized by the total number of terms in the document. It is usually denoted by TF, indicating that the term frequency for a term is determined by the term frequency T, and its document length D. IDF stands for inverse document frequency, which measures how frequently a term appears in the whole corpus. This is important because certain terms may appear a lot of times in a document but also appear a lot of times in other documents in the corpus, which makes it not so special for the document. Therefore, we need to weigh down such terms and scale up the weights of the terms not frequent across all the documents. In the IDF formula, N is the total number of documents in the corpus and DF is the document frequency of the term. 1 is added to the logarithm part of the IDF to prevent zeroing out the terms that appear in every document in the corpus. When a term appears in all the documents, the numerator and denominator have the same value, so the result is 1. Log on equals 0, so IDF equals 0 and hence TF-IDF equals 0. Adding 1 to the equation makes the value in the logarithm always greater than 1, which prevents zeroing out terms from happening. Adding 1 to the numerator and denominator of the equation prevents zero division. We can think of it as adding an extra document with all the terms in the corpus. Fitting the input text using TF-IDF vectorizer from Sclearn automatically creates IDs for each vocabulary in the corpus. Same as the count vectorization, in the example corpus with two sentences, data science is fun. And data science helps us to make data-driven decisions. TF-IDF vectorizer assigned IDs from 0 to 9 to the 10 unique words in alphabetical order. Transform method produces the TF-IDF vector values. Question 8. What is bag of words? The bag of words model is a type of NLP model that represents text using the count of words. The order of the words is not considered. The predictions of the models are based on which words appear in a document and how many times they appeared. The NLP preprocessing steps such as tokenization, removing stop words, removing punctuation, stemming or lemmatization, and vectorization are usually applied before running a bag of words model. Question 9. What is word embedding? Word embedding in NLP is a technique to represent the meaning of words with vectors. Words with similar semantics are close to each other in the vector space. Mathematical computation can be applied to word embeddings for semantic calculation. For example, the word embedding for king minus man plus woman will give us the word embedding for the word queen. Embedding can also be used for dimensionality reduction. To learn how to use embedding to feature engineer high cardinality variables, please check out my previous tutorial Categorical Entity Embedding using Python TensorFlow Keras. The link for the tutorial will be put in the video descriptions. Question 10. What are Virtuovec, CBOW, and Skipgram? Virtuovec is a type of neural network model for natural language processing that produces word embeddings based on the training text corpus. The resulting word vectors can be used as features in other machine learning and deep learning models. There are two main learning algorithms in Virtuovec, continuous bag of words and Skipgram. The continuous bag of words architecture predicts the current word based on the context words, and the Skipgram predicts surrounding words given the current word. Skipgram is slow and better for infrequent words, while CBOW is fast. The context size is usually around 10 for Skipgram and around 5 for CBOW. Below is a diagram from the Virtuovec paper showing the difference between continuous bag of words and Skipgram. The quality of the word vectors is crucial because it affects the downstream task's performance. The quality of the word vectors are mainly affected by three factors: corpus size and quality for the training dataset, the size of the word vectors. The dimensionality of the word vectors is usually more is better, but not always. The training model structure and algorithm. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about data science interview, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.